All right, so I'm just recording this video to test out the dev tools. One of my coders was having issues getting the dev tools with Spring Dev Tools set up, so I'm just going to sort of do a real time walkthrough of what I see in terms of my run through of using dev tools and see if it sort of functions as I would expect it to. So the first thing I did was I went to help and I said check for updates, and I was sure to make sure that my Spring Tool Suite was the most up-to-date version. There's a bunch of updates that I just applied, so should be good to go. So now I'll say File New Spring Starter Project, and I will call this application the Dev Tools example, I guess. And I'll use Dev Tools example as the package. Okay, demo project, Maven 1.8, etc., etc. So now I'm going to use web timeleaf dependencies, and this student was saying that he was looking at using the dev tools. So let's see if there it is, core dev tools, boom, boom. So I'm going to add that as well to my project and say finish. So it'll fire up my creation of my DevTools example. So now inside of this project, once this is all done, I'll just say run in the background for now. Or maybe not, because this is not done. We need to wait for it to do its thing. Importing, blah, 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 downloading. So I haven't done DevTools yet, so that's why it has to download a bunch of DevTools stuff. So there we go. So now it seems like we're getting there. Okay, so we've got our DevTools example application file with the Spring Boot application annotation. So what I'll do is I'll go ahead and create a new class. I'll just call this the test controller. I'll annotate it with at controller, and I will do a request mapping. We'll just have it map to the root URL with the request method get. Public string, you know, root. Model map, return, I don't know, index or something. Control Shift O to import all of my dependencies and whatnot, which didn't seem like it did anything. Control Shift O, interesting. So that's a little bit perturbing. I don't know why my Control Shift O doesn't work. Oh yeah, value equals. Okay, so in here, import. Cool. So now let's create our, let me make sure that this is all good. Okay. So let me make sure, or let me go ahead and create a, inside templates, an index file. So I'll say file index.html. And this will just be standard HTML file, doc type HTML. Let's see, head. With a title, test, body, and we'll do XML namespace for timeleaf.org. TH text equals this is a test. /p. Cool. So we've got our controller set up. It should, you know, redirect to the index file, which is here. I forgot to make the test controller or nest it into its own package. So usually I do a .web package. We should move the test controller into the web package. Very important that we do that. Okay, so let's go ahead and run this as a Spring Boot app. And hopefully we won't get any errors. Okay, it looks like it started up properly. So I'll say localhost. So that should say this is a test. Very good. So now if I go into index and change this to say, you know, blah, blah, and save it, hopefully it'll pick up that change. And there it is, blah, blah. So I think this is the problem that my student was having where it wasn't, it's not picking up the changes as he makes the changes to this and says save and refreshes the HTML page. I don't think that stuff is coming up. He has to reboot his entire server in order to see that stuff. The other part that DevTools apparently is supposed to be good for is rebooting your server on the fly if you make a change. So if I say .put, you know, some sort of data and say this is some sample data, it's supposed to almost act like Spring Loaded, where it refreshes everything. So that's what just happened there. It just rebooted the server. So instead of Spring Loaded, where Spring Loaded doesn't reboot the server, when a change is made, Spring Loaded will try to do a hot swap, but that doesn't always work, especially if you're changing something like the name of a method, or if you're changing something like an annotation, so changes to be test and say save. That's where Spring Loaded would have troubles, whereas Spring, the DevTools here, will reboot the server automatically. So now if we go into index and type in another P and say th text equals data, it should be able to bring in that data as well. I changed it to be slash test. So this is some sample data. So it should be able to, test. It'll reboot the server, test. And we should also, if we want to do this and remove that, it should also reboot the server. And then we go into /, instead of /test, and it looks like that's working. Because now if I go to /test, it'll say white label page error or whatever. So it looks like that's working properly. So hopefully the student who is having issues with this will be able to, see what I've done, and hopefully his setup will work. So again, there's really just three files. One, I have a root package with com, Coders Campus, DevTool example, but you can do whatever you like for the package names. There's a DevTools example application file with a Spring Boot application annotation and the public static void main method. There's a servlet initializer, which automatically gets created. Here's what that looks like. So if you need to, you can pause the video and look at this code. And then I have my test controller, which just has everything that we've seen already. In the templates directory, I have my index file. And then the application properties file, we actually don't need to include. Normally, I would do the caching. So Spring timeleaf cache equals false. So normally, this is what I would do in my application properties file, but when you include inside of your POM file, when you include the dev tools here, this artifact, when you include the dev tools, apparently that sets it to be false by default. Had I not included dev tools, then I would need to add this property in my application properties file. So if I go back and refresh, everything looks fine, and if I go and change some stuff here, like more words, I should be able to just see them. Yeah, so it shouldn't make a difference whether or not you have the Spring timeleaf cache. But if you have it as true, then that's where, so my server will restart. That's where if I make a change to the file here and say test and save it and refresh. Oh, you do see the test. So test, two more tests. Does it reboot the server? No. There we go. So now you see it didn't show up test because it's caching this file now. So that's why there's nothing else showing up when I save it. There's nothing happening in terms of the server's not restarting because it's just HTML. And if I refresh here, it's not showing up. So I believe that's the problem that this student was having, was he's making changes to the HTML file and nothing is changing. He has to reboot his whole server like so. If I click reboot, only then will it pick up the additional test with more garbage at the end, right? So hopefully we'll see two more tests here. There we go. So that's the problem, right? So and the reason being is because we have caching set as true. But if you don't set any caching, then by default, it should automatically set caching to be false. So if we refresh this page and then obviously go back and add more to the end of it, like some exclamation marks, that should pick it up immediately without rebooting the server. There you go. So hopefully that helps. This particular student's still having trouble, hopefully we can figure it out in some way, shape, or form through the Facebook group. So, there you go. Have fun. Happy learning. Bye for now.